picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
LOV on my right leg, that's Gucci. What I'm saying, hell of you on my man, that's Poochie. Dig what I'm saying, caught a little jet lag, but I'm golden. Yeah, we deserve Grammys and some Oscars. Yeah, they deserve Whammies, they imposters. I be rolling with my project homies, it's a vibe. I just put the homie, it's a vibe. Over switch sides, it's a vibe. Yeah, yeah. I gon' do what you gon' do, what you gon' do. I gotta accept that I'm a yeah, yeah. I pull up in several different options. Yeah, yeah. That I would most ever, I shatter your dreams with this cream I make, What? Gotta be on, the thinker. I say, what? I can't feel my toes, but ain't gon' fold up, I was in the double law when I rolled,
I've been rolling on the freeway, I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got milkings on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe. I've been rolling on the freeway, I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got milkings on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe.
Dig what I'm saying, Janelle Drake's on me daily, dig. Dig what I'm saying, sponsored by Mercedes, dig. Dig what I'm saying, this Creek Cologne is on me, baby, dig. Dig what I'm saying, I'm going hard, yeah. I pop in your memory, You should be glad I'm showing you sympathy, I gave you real love out the gutter, Ever let you go, you gon' suffer from it. I gon' do it, I gotta accept that I'm a I pull up in several different options, that I would most.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's the Browns going up against the Titans.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. This fielded at the two. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Broken tackle, can't go very far. Stop short of the 30. A gain of three, second down. Kaiser now on second down. Complete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
My high school coach John Ford used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
Now they'll bootleg it with Kaiser. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. A big play there on third down for the Browns. 45 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Let's go! 38.
A first down carry now for Crowell. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Isaiah Crowell, 27 yards. And the Browns take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. It's up and through to make it 7-0 Browns. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Carry for Derrick Henry. Oh, he bowls over him. No gain on the play there. Second down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is.
Not just a big man, a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for
weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A gain of 39 that time. They go play action here on first down. Rolling to his left. And an alley to run. And he slides to avoid the hit. 11 more yards that go around. A first down as well.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now a play fake here on first down. Flush to his right. Finding room to the 20. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They begin with a run by Crowell. And he's going to be taken down right at about the 15-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Play fake. Kaiser, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. With it is Jackson. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Titans are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over first and 10. Now the Titans getting set to go. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, That does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
So the D-line's going to spread out. From the red zone now, Mariota. Forced out to his left. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
I like the play call. Roll him out. Give him a chance to run it or throw it. In this situation, he decided to fling it, but couldn't find his man open.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Mariota. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. That'll go as a loss of five. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. And that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Here's Ryan Succop for the Titan field goal. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And Succop will put this one right through, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, but no problems converting there.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And the Browns getting set to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. A first down throw for Kaiser. Throw left side complete. That's Gordon. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second down, here's Crowell. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. And give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football. On play action, Kaiser. Flushed out right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Wesley Woodyard. In there to get him for a loss of 9. And that'll lead to 4th down. Now on 4th down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Kaiser and the offense staying put. They're going for it. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Indeed going. It's Kaiser. And he's going to go down again. Derek Morgan, the outside linebacker, drops him for a loss of 6. And Charles, they just handed them a gift. Going for it there, that spot of the field inside the 24.
Yeah, sometimes you think you've got plenty of time in a game, so you take a little bit of a crazy risk. This goes in the category of a crazy, crazy, crazy risk. Yeah, I'm giving you 3 on that one. But how about on the defensive side of the ball? To see them come out, line up, and decide to go for it there, You figure there's no way we're giving this one up. We're going to turn the ball over for our own offense and get some points out of it.
And they did the first part of that. Now they'll be looking to add those points with great field position. Taken down right at the line. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. On third down, Mariota eluding the pressure right. And he fires one, but incomplete.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. And Succop will put this one right through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So that's their third trip to the red zone, but all they have to show so far is two field goals.
Tough sledding in this game for the offense. They get to the red zone. Normally you count on a minimum of 3 points in each red zone trip. Not so far in this game.
And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Here we go! Flex round!
From the gun, Kaiser. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gordon. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Big yardage there for the Browns, 18.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second down, Kaiser. This is caught. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another first down.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Did he just clock that? Looked like he tried to stop the clock, but the clock wasn't even moving. This offense on third down today, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and goal. Working out of the gun. Here's Kaiser. And this is going to be incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
They'll try and throw for it with Kessler. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. Oh, that was an intriguing call. You got a chip shot field goal. Tight game. Why not just take the three?
I know that not all the old rules apply in today's NFL. And in fact, I'd love to have an analytics coach here with us right now to say why that was probably a good play. I don't know that even the analytics coach would have said that. That seemed like a bad play. Take the points there and move on. Well, not a game that you're going to go crazy about, but when you start at your own two-yard line.
Now the ball comes loose, and this is picked up by the Browns. Oh, he's got a little daylight.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble. From what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around. And we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Kizer now after the fumble recovery. The ball comes out. It's picked up by the Titans. Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. Dances by him. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now Mariota. And complete to the tight end Walker, right side. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one good for a pickup of 15 for Tennessee.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Mariota on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Mariota now to throw on first down. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
On second down, here's Henry. And an alley to run! And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. First down, Titans, gain of 12.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot. Picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Derrick Henry, a 15-yard touchdown run. And the Titans are able to strike for 6. Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for 2 field goals. This time, they come away with 6.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range, but couldn't quite finish it off. This time, they broke through. That's great for the old confidence.
And on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6, is it astronomical or no?
It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
Now here's Succop out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. Gets past one man. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. They'll run it again with Crowell. And he's got Rome. It's a big play there for the Browns. 42 yards on the ground.
But we know one thing. Isaiah Crowell can run if given an opportunity. Had the longest run in the NFL in 2016. An 85-yard touchdown sprint week 2 against Baltimore.
This one not quite as long. Didn't end in 6, but still great game. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards.
I'm still an old school football guy, and anytime you see a big time running play, that fires me up. And if I'm on offense right now, in the position they're in now, inside the 10-yard line, I think after the way they've run it, they've set themselves up for a good play action pass opportunity right here.
Flush to his right, fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And this will get out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Back now in Nashville. It's the Browns with a deficit. They're trailing, but with the football here to start the 4th. Shift together here from the D-line. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and punch it in with Crowell. And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Isaiah Crowell, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And an important one that is, as we are tied now early in this 4th quarter. set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
They'll get this to his tight end. It's Jonnu Smith. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. He got 29 yards that time. A first down carry for Henry. And some room to Derrick Henry all alone. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Titans are going to take the lead. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but two TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. This is fielded at the goal line. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here comes the Browns offense back onto the field. And it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get.
A battle for it, and it's intercepted. LeSean Sims with the INT. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And they had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. Flushed out right. They find some open field here. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice gain.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he brings this up to the 46. Good enough for the first. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. They keep it with Henry on first down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. First down, Titans, gain of 12.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
One of his main targets, Delanie Walker, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Mariota gives to Henry. And he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. The Titans on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This time it's third and three. Again with Henry. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. The Titans get 14 yards there and move the chains as well. I think this defense tired of seeing him run the football, and this D-line probably getting sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about a conversation I had with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asked his running backs each week for their favorite runs. Give me your three top runs. And right now, you're seeing a guy that's probably using his top runs to great advantage in this game.
He is in a zone. Mariota, hands to Henry. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Now here's Suck about to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a
rush coming, and he's taken down. They hustle to the line offensively. Kaiser urging them to move faster.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle.
Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Derek Morgan in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. So a tough spot for Kaiser. The sack, and now it's third and long.
Here we go. Red, left round.
They go play action. Kaiser. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Fourth down, Kaiser, desperation time. And he goes down, it's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Mariota here to throw, sliding out of the pocket. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Well, as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lamb, yeah, a little extra on top.
Now the final act of this victory, the extra point.
Partner, that type of a lead, and they're going to fake it, backs from the 15 to try and pick up a two-point play instead of kicking it through the post. Come on, man. Put that in mothballs. Come on. Come on. Don't do that.
Put that in mothballs.
Yeah, preserve that for it. That's an ancient relic, faking it. I can understand you want to rub it in a little. You fake it when you snapped it from the 3. But from the 15, mothball that bad boy, just like my grandmother had.
Yeah,
in her attic, the stuff she used to preserve.
My grandmother did the same. It smelled terrible.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Titans are winners here as we say so long from Nashville.